So today I am going to continue with the chapter accounting ratios. Okay, accounting ratios. Not share capital, it is a ratio. So we discussed what are accounting ratios. Okay. Accounting ratios are very important tool. It is a tool used for financial statement analysis. We know financial statements are the trading and profit and loss account, balance sheet. In order to analyze that, we make use of accounting ratio. So what is ratio? It is a mathematical number calculated as a reference to relationship between two or more numbers. It shows the relationship between two or more items, and we can express it either in the form of a fraction, proportion, percentage, or also as number of times. Okay, that is all discussed, and we also saw what are the objectives of ratio analysis. Objectives of ratio analysis. Then we discussed about the two types of ratios, traditional classification as well as functional classification. Traditional means it is when we use the items to be compared either from the profit and loss account or balance sheet or a combination of both these. One item from profit and loss account, another item from balance sheet. Such expressions or finding out relationship between such items, that is termed as traditional classification. But now we are going to learn in detail about functional classification of ratios. Okay, functional classification. In that, the first kind of ratio is liquidity ratios. Liquidity. What do you understand by liquidity? Liquidity means ability to convert easily into cash. Am I right? It is the ability of the assets to be converted easily into cash. So, why is these calculated? For what? See, business definitely require money. Funds are required. Liquid funds are required by the business in order to meet its commitments. That we know that. The ability of the business to pay the amount due to stakeholders as and when it is due is known as liquidity. Okay? So whatever obligations the business have towards its stakeholders, whether the business is able to meet them quickly, easily, immediately, without any delay, that is called liquidity. Okay? Their financial obligations are met without much delay. That is called liquidity, and the ratios calculated to measure it, whether they have sufficient liquid funds with them. The ratios which are used to calculate that are called liquidity ratios. So actually, these liquidity ratios, they are calculated to measure the short-term solvency. Important, underline, short-term solvency of the business. Short-term, now current obligations. Okay, their requirements currently. It tells us about short-term financial soundness of a company. Short-term, for a short period of time, whether the company is able to meet its current obligations, short-term obligations. Okay, so it is for that we use liquidity ratios. Okay, so what is the condition of a company in the short term? Short term, okay, that is the word important here. Short term obligations, short term solvency, liquidity ratios. Now, liquidity ratios, we have two types of ratios. Current ratio, quick ratio. Liquidity ratios are of two types. Current ratio and quick ratio. Current ratio, how to find out current ratio? Current ratio is equal to current assets divided by current liabilities. Okay, current. Currently, what is the financial position of the company? Now, at present, how is the financial soundness of the company? How much current assets are available to meet the current liabilities? That is what current ratio tells us. And here we have an ideal ratio also. Ideal ratio. Ideal current ratio is 2:1. Very important. 2:1. That is the ideal one. When you calculate the current ratio, if you find that it is 2:1, that means it is good enough. Double the current liabilities. Current assets are double the current liabilities. This means current assets should be always, or it should be twice the current liability. That means it is having a very good financial soundness. Okay, so note down the formula. Current ratio is equal to current assets divided by current liabilities. This is easy, but as we move forward, we have several ratios, so you shouldn't get confused, or don't get confused. That's all. So this is based on this, we will be doing the project. After the examination, you will select a balance sheet, and whatever ratios are taught here, you will find it out from that particular balance sheet. So from your balance sheet, you will find out the current ratio. So current ratio is equal to current asset divided by current liabilities. Now, what are these current assets? Current assets includes, these are all the current assets. Current investments, inventories, trade receivables. Trade receivables means it includes both debtors and bills receivables. Debtors, sundry debtors, and if it is in the document form, bill of exchange, it becomes bills receivables. Cash and cash equivalents. Short-term loans and advances. And it also includes other current assets such as prepaid expense, advance tax, and accrued income, etc., etc. So these are the current assets usually that we find in the balance sheet. And again, what are the current liabilities? Current liabilities include all these: short-term borrowings, trade payables, it includes creditors and bills payable, other current liabilities, and short-term provisions. Okay, now for what is the significance? Why is it important to find out the current ratio? It provides a measure of degree to which current assets cover current liabilities. How much current assets are available? How much current liabilities are there? Okay, whether current liabilities are more or current assets are more, what is the relationship between the current asset and current liability? The excess of current assets over current liability provides a measure of safety margin. If current assets are more, then it is good. That shows the safety margin available against uncertainty. The ratio should be reasonable. It shouldn't be either high or very low. It should be reasonable. A very high current ratio, it is not good. That means there is so much of current assets with the company. Unnecessary investments in current assets. Again, if it is very low, that is also not good. A low ratio endangers the business and put it at risk of facing a situation where it will not be able to pay its short-term debt on time. So always it is better to maintain the current ratio, I mean the current assets and current liabilities in the ratio 2:1. The company should always try to maintain the current assets and current liabilities in the ratio 2:1. Okay, so this is about current assets. I'm sorry, current ratio. Current ratio is equal to current assets divided by current liabilities. Now, let us see how to do this as a problem. A balance sheet is given to you. Okay, balance sheet. This is your question number one in the numerical session. Okay. A balance sheet is given to you. Yes. Balance sheet, liabilities as well as assets are given, and you are asked to find out current ratio. Simple one. So current ratio is equal to current asset divided by current liabilities. Current assets divided by current liabilities. Now look at the balance sheet and see which are the current assets. Four items are given in the asset side. Fixed asset, we know it is fixed asset. It is directly given, it is fixed asset. So it shouldn't be included. Rest three are the current assets. So what we do? First of all, always write the formula. Current ratio is equal to current asset divided by current liabilities. Okay. Now, current assets is equal to, we have stock, debtors, cash at bank. Add all the three. Stock plus debtors plus cash at bank. ₹55,800 + ₹28,800 + ₹59,400. That will give you 1,44,000. Okay. Now the next step is to find out current liabilities. Current liabilities, look on to the liability side of the balance sheet. Only two are there. Bills payable and creditors. Bills payable and creditors. Add both of that together, you get 72,000. Solve it. Current assets 1,44,000 divided by current liabilities 72,000. Okay. So when you solve this, you find that it is 2:1. That's all. This is how we find out current ratio. Okay. Finish. Tomlin, switch on the video. Okay, I hope it's over. Now, that is about current ratio. And the next category is liquid ratios. Liquid ratios. Okay? Liquid ratio. Both of this comes under liquidity ratio. Under the category liquidity ratio. And the second one is liquid ratio. Liquid ratio, the another name for it is quick ratio. Quick ratio as well as acid test ratio. Liquid ratio, quick ratio, acid test ratio. These are the three names. Okay. Now here we are finding out the relation between or the ratio between liquid asset or quick assets to current liabilities. Earlier it was current asset by current liability, but here it is liquid asset, or you can say quick assets divided by current liabilities. Okay. So, these all the three names are important. Asset test ratio, quick ratio, liquid ratio. Formula is liquid assets divided by current liabilities. So all the current assets are not considered here. We need only the liquid assets. Now how to find the liquid asset? Okay. Now, what are quick assets? Quick assets are those which are quickly convertible into cash. More faster than the current assets. The quick assets are defined as those assets which are quickly convertible into cash are or are already in the form of cash. Okay. The whatever money you have in your purse, you, if you have 100 rupee notes in your purse, that means it is a quick asset. It is already in the form of cash. You can quickly take and use it. So that is quick asset. Or cash at bank, whatever cash is available in your bank account, that is easily usable. So while calculating quick asset, what to do with now? We just have to exclude inventories, okay, and also prepaid expense, advanced tax, etc. from the current asset. Current asset minus inventories, that will give you what? Quick asset. Non-liquid assets are excluded. So this will give you the liquidity position of the business. Liquidity position of the business. Liquidity position of the business. So note down to get the liquid assets. From the list of current assets given, just reduce prepaid expenses and inventories. Prepaid expenses, inventories, advance tax. When these are excluded, you get liquid assets. There is no change with current liability. Okay, so liquid assets divided by current liability will give you asset test ratio, that is quick ratio. Okay, let's do the problem. So, two ratios, current ratio and liquid ratio. Okay, we are going to do the problem on liquid ratio. So, again, a balance sheet is given to you. You are going to find out. So, in this question, both current ratio as well as liquid ratio. You are asked to find out current ratio as well as liquid ratio, both of that. So, first of all, we'll find out the current ratio. So, what is current ratio? Current assets divided by current liabilities. Now, check. Building, stock, debtors, cash in hand, prepaid expenses. So, building is a fixed asset. No need to include that. Add up all other current assets, you get the total of current assets. Stock plus debtors plus cash in hand plus prepaid expenses. Now, next one is find out current liabilities. Current liabilities will include bank overdraft, creditors, provision for taxation. Provision for taxation. Okay. So add that. Both current asset, current liability, find out the ratio. Current asset divided by current liability.
Now, current ratio should be 4:5 now. You got 8:1.
Yeah, it is 4:5. 4 divided by 5, that is 0.8. 0.8 divided by 1. You get 0.8 divided by 1. That's why it is written as 0.8:1. Okay. You may stop with 4:5. That is a ratio. I mean, that is a fraction. 4:5. Okay. You may stop with that. That is okay. That's okay. Now again, when 4 is divided by 5, you get 0.8. So 0.8:1. Simply 0.8 means, that means the denominator is 1. Am I right? Point 8:1. Now coming to liquid ratio, it is liquid assets divided by current liabilities. Current liabilities, there is no change. It is same as the previous one. Same calculation. You don't have to calculate it again. But liquid assets, how will you find liquid assets? I told you, from the current assets, whatever current assets you have, reduce stock and prepaid expenses from that. Stock and prepaid expenses have to be excluded. That means Or you can say, you can just take debtors plus cash in hand. That will give you what? Liquid assets. You don't have to take stock on and prepaid expenses. Liquid assets includes only debtors and cash in hand. Okay, and liquid assets, I forgot to mention, the ideal ratio, ideal liquid ratio is 1:1. Okay, these are all expected questions for MCQ. Ideal ratio of ideal ratio for current ratio is 2:1 and liquid ratio is 1:1. So look at the ratios. Current ratio is only 0.8:1. So is it good or bad? The ideal ratio is, 2:1, and here we have only 0.8:1. So it is not, just a second. So the company has to concentrate more upon the current assets. They need to add more current assets. It is not a healthy status now. Okay. Moving to the next question. This is a different type question. There is slight change in this. See, current ratio is given. Current ratio is 3.1:1. Okay. Current ratio is given 3.5:1. Now the working capital is given to you 90,000. Then we are asked to find out how much is current asset, how much is current liability. Okay. Directly the ratio is given to you, that is 3.5:1. This is the current ratio. And you are only given information about working capital. Working capital. Now, calculate the amount of current asset and current liability. We should find out how much is the current asset, how much is current liability. Okay, hope the question is clear. So the first thing we do is we will write the formula first. Current asset is equal to, current ratio is equal to current asset divided by current liability. Write down the formula first. Okay. Now, what is the information given to you? It is said that current asset is divided by current liability. Current ratio is 3.5:1. 3.5:1. That means it is 3.5 divided by 1. Yes. 3.5 divided by 1 is equal to current assets divided by current liability. Okay, no? So we can say that cross multiply this. Yes, Irfan? What happened, Irfan?
Nothing.